We've all heard the saying, the sky's the limit. But it seems to me there's always a ceiling in the way. I sometimes imagine what it would be like if there was another me. Like, what if there was someone that was exactly you, and basically was you, but they did the opposite version of whatever you did? Hey, I fucked a cow today. Seriously? Why? What, have you done that before? No. Well, that's why. But that's not the opposite. That's just you doing that. Or, what if there was another you that you just got to bully for free? Get out.
Right on.
Or maybe you had a doppelganger, but the thing was, they spoke a different language than you.
Hey, what's up? Hola, ¿dónde está la biblioteca?
What the fuck am I doing? What the fuck is all this?
Hola, ¿dónde está la biblioteca?
Why am I so aggressive?
Hey, yo, where's the library? Hello, do you know where the library is? Hello, do you know where the library is? Hola, ¿dónde está la biblioteca?
What the fuck is Hello, where's the library?
I think it would be cool if there was a lookalike that would just tell you the time whenever you asked.
Hey, what time is it?
Oh shit, he's not here.
Oh, it's 12.
Never mind, I was just throwing that idea out there, I was just spitballing, and that idea is not cool. Someone made it known to me that I'm really pale, and it wasn't really obvious to me before. So now, every other day, especially when it's sunny, I stand by the window and I tan.
I do it this way because it's safer. That way a raccoon doesn't come piss on me.
I've noticed that a lot of those videos that give relationship advice or any form of advice, in the video, they're doing the most random things. It doesn't even matter what subject of advice they're giving, because they make it seem like they have the key to any problem you'll ever have. I went around my house looking for objects and things, and eventually I just set my camera down in different locations and just started recording and did what they do.
This TV is off. But follow it. Fuck. This TV is off. And it's a representation that your third mind is also off. Follow me, and together, I can help you open up that third mind of yours.
Seashells. But they're not by the sea. So does that mean they're lost? No. They're just finding their own path in life. We're all trying to do this in our own ways. Sometimes we need guidance in the right direction. Whether it be questions, whether it be situations, whether it be experiences. You're like the seashell in someone's house.
I'm sure you've all heard the saying, the sky's the limit. But it seems to me, we've all heard the saying, the sky's the limit. But it seems to me, there's always a ceiling in the way. Now we need to deconstruct that ceiling, so that way we can reach that limitless sky. Follow me if you want to be on this journey. Get this advice, and be the better you.
Look at this turtle. It's made of stone, and it's stuck. Much like you probably are in your relationship with your significant other. Now if you want to be unstuck, you can't look directly at Medusa in the eyes. You'll turn to stone. Gotta go around. Don't direct. Because oftentimes, go direct, you get stuck.
What the fuck am I saying?
This is a green skull. It's a skull, and humans have skulls. The green represents envy. My cat just sneezed. In agreement with me. The green represents envy, because humans are envious creatures. I'm gonna kiss this skull now. Wait, you don't have lips. Oh, that's fine by me. I'm feeling like a million, baby.
I'm feeling like a stranger, baby. Hey, how come whenever we play rock, paper, scissors, you always pick rock?